What's going on, all of my healthcare brothers and sisters? I hope that you are having a wonderful day. Today, we're going to be talking about something that's near and dear to my heart, and that is the cardiac coronary circulation. Let's get started. So just like our systemic circulation, the heart also needs oxygenation in order to pump appropriately and maintain its function. So that is why we have our coronary vessels. So the right coronary artery, which is known as the RCA, and the left coronary artery, also known as the LCA, provides blood flow to the heart. Both arteries are a branch off of our aorta. So let's begin by looking at our LMCA. That's our left main coronary artery. So the location, it's going to originate from the left aortic sinus above the aortic valve. And it branches into our left anterior descending artery and our circumflex artery. And primarily what this coronary vessel does is it perfuses the left side of the heart. So just to back up and think about it, the coronary circulation is a way that the heart supplies blood to itself, right? We talked about in our previous video that if there's any kind of blockage or something impeding blood flow, that part of the heart is eventually going to die if it's located in our coronary vessels. So as long as they're healthy and they're clean and they're good, this coronary system is going to help supply blood to itself so that it can perform the functions that it needs to. When it comes to the left side of the heart, the coronary arteries are providing blood to our left atrium, our left ventricle, and part of the septum, which is kind of just down the middle of our heart. When it comes to the right side of our heart, we have our right atrium, right ventricle, part of the septum, as well as our sinoatrial node, our SA node, and our AV node are being perfused by those coronary arteries. So when it comes to our nodes, they're responsible for that electrical activity that takes place in our heart. So if there's any kind of blockage in our RCA, what do you think we're gonna see? If we've got an issue with electricity, we're going to see dysrhythmias, right? Absolutely. So we know that if there's some kind of blockage on the right, we're probably going to see some kind of dysrhythmia taking place. You will find that there are more coronary vessels on the left side of the heart because the left side of the heart is much larger than the right side and it really requires more perfusion. So we know that that left side of the heart is pumping blood out into our systemic circulation. So that's why we need a little bit of an extra space as well as more perfusion to that part of the heart. And then lastly, if you find that certain vessels are more susceptible to blockages, you're going to be thinking about your RCA, your LMCA, your LAD, which is the left anterior descending, as well as that left circumflex artery. So let's move on to some different ones so we can start breaking these down and why these are so important. So moving down from that left main coronary artery, we have our left anterior descending artery, also known as our LAD. And that again is located on the left lateral part of the heart. So this branches into our diagonals, and what our diagonals do is they supply blood flow to the anterior and anterolateral walls of the left ventricle. And then we have our septal perforators, and what they do is they supply blood to the anterior and inferior intraventricular arteries, interventricular septum, as well as our conduction system. What this does is it perfuses the left and bottom of the left ventricle, the front of the septal wall, as well as the bundle of His, which we'll be talking about in a separate video. So the left anterior descending artery is sometimes known as the widowmaker when there is a huge blockage that occurs in this artery. Because what happens is the LAD is a major pipeline of blood, and if blood gets blocked at that critical location, it is highly fatal for our patients if there's no emergency interventions that take place as soon as there is a blockage of that artery. All right, next we have our circumflex artery. So this is again located on the left posterior side of the heart, and it branches into our marginal, which is the branch that supplies the blood to the lateral portion of the right ventricle and our obtuse marginal. And again, this particular artery perfuses the left atrium, the posterior and lateral walls of the left ventricle, as well as the SA node and posterior descending artery. So we talked about everything going on the left side of the heart, and now let's take a closer look at what's happening on the right side of the heart. So to begin, we have our right coronary artery, also known as our RCA. And this originates from the right aortic sinus at the bottom of the aorta. So this is branching into our acute marginal, our interventricular, as well as that SA node. So it's going to perfuse the right atrium, as well as the right ventricle, the bottom of both ventricles, as well as the back of the septum. We have our SA and our AV nodes being perfused. That's the electricity of our heart. And the bundle of His, as well as the posterior descending artery, also known as the PDA. And with this particular artery, it's highly, highly susceptible to blockages. So we have to keep a very close eye on this artery as well. And lastly, we're going to be looking at the posterior descending artery, also known as our PDA. And this is located on the posterior side of the heart, and it branches from that right coronary artery that we just talked about. And what this particular artery perfuses is that posterior wall of the left ventricle, as well as the back of the septum. So lastly, how are the coronary arteries perfused? So the heart contracts during systole, causing the aortic valve to open. This action will block coronary circulation because we know that it's located right at the base of the aorta, right? So if it opens, it's blocking blood from flowing into our coronary arteries. Once the heart relaxes in diastole, it's going to cause those aortic valves to close. So blood is going to back up against the aortic valves, and that pause is going to allow blood to flow in to our coronary arteries. So that's how they get their perfusion. But sometimes there's problems. So what seems to be the problem, officer? Well, if we have tachycardias, tachycardias are going to reduce that pause time between our diastole and systole. So if we reduce this pause, do you think the coronary arteries are going to have time to perfuse? Absolutely not. So there's not going to be a whole lot of time for that blood to back into the coronary arteries. So the heart really relies on that ability of having that brief pause to provide perfusion to the coronary arteries. I hope that this video was helpful in understanding the cardiovascular system. If you have any additional questions, make sure that you leave them down below. I love answering your questions. Make sure you follow me on my social media. I'm on Facebook as well as Instagram. And if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe here on YouTube and turn that bell notification on so that you're notified every time I post a new video. Head over to www.nursechung.com where there's additional resources as well as questions when it comes to the cardiovascular system. But until next time, I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I will see you all again soon. Bye.